putting on the brakes now. Got us some real Kennewick railroading going on. Not sure what short line this is. He's got a string of dang old reefer cars, UP reefer cars. He's disappearing around where I can see. There he goes. I'll see if I can't find him somewhere up the line farther where I can get a better shot. I was just looking on Google Maps and saw the top of this locomotive on one of the spots I was looking at, wondering what the crap it was, and then I came across it and there it is right there, so I'm getting it. About five more of these bad boys to go by and in a bunch of traffic and a clear. I don't know if they got a line behind on that switch or what. I don't know their operation out here. I think that's a Y switch right there. They might have come around the Y the other way. Not quite sure where I'm at. Oh, look at that little Fred on that thing. It's a little air pressure gauge. Never seen that before. That's pretty cool. Well, there's their switchman right there. Protecting their shove. Holy cow. Here's the other guy. Right here. Well, he was. Maybe he did line behind. Oh, there's his train off there in the distance. Maybe he's walking up. And now this other guy gonna line behind him or something. I don't know what the heck's going on here. They're making a passing move right here somehow. This is all too weird. I don't know what's going on. Now they're stopping. They're probably going to shove back because they had a guy on the ground down there. And I think he's backing up. Yep. He's shoving in somewhere else. And I think that other guy had to line himself into his own track, throw the switch back to normal, and then walk up to the head in, and they'll be taken off, and then I'm just watching this guy shove. Oh, he's even riding the shove. I can't even focus on the dude's numbers. He's so about a half a mile down the street from me. Probably shoving back over to his own stuff. Okay, that's enough.
Bye.
Well, we're coming from Wishram into Pasco, just getting ready to cross the Columbia River. Look at that! Mighty Columbia. Wind blowing and everything down here today. Not quite. There it is. So let's get a view of the train swinging around the curve here. Okay, that's where I caught him coming in. And now I'll give you all a headache. Whee! He's trying to do a little bit better job of filming here. He's almost to the other side. Here. Oops. There he is, coming off the bridge. Look at that. Gonna disappear into the sunset. Whoops, crap. If there was a sunset. See ya. I think we'll get him one more time right here. I've zoomed out as far as I can go, clear across the other side of the river. I don't know if we'll see him again or not. Let's kind of see where he's going. Oh yeah, there he goes. The wind is blowing the camera a little bit. It's jittery. This is how far out I'm zoomed here to the other side of the river. Yeah, baby. Railfanning, Tri-City style. The last car. Got a little bit of a brake squeaking. ABF. I need me one of those. Anybody want to build me one and send it to me? He's squeaking like he's got a handbrake on. He might be running in minimum reduction though. I don't know. Sure not Johnny Schwartz running, because he'd be in run 8 right now, right into the yard. Look out, here I come. Clunk, clunk. Over that gap on that lift span. Look at that lift span. Much down for the trains and up for the barges when they show up, and that's it. Man, you can still hear that thing squeaking halfway across the river. I hear another one right behind him. Remember, send your 53. Thank you. We'll set up the next shot for the next train. Bye-bye now. He's moving really slow. And I mean really slow. Come on out of there, you little skunk. He might have to sit and wait for the block. He might not be filming him. He might just stop right there. Unless they gave him a head in already, but he doesn't have a block. He's creeping up to a stop. Yeah, he's stopping right there. Is he stopped? He stopped. Okay, we'll turn the camera back on when he's moving. Well, this is what it looks like. The other one on the other side of the river is waiting for. We got a yard move down here or something. A couple of tank cars. Former BN 40-2, 1836. I don't know if they're waiting for a block to get across the river. They had a yellow block, but maybe they just needed it to... Yeah, I think there's another block signal right behind that. It's one that's lit up for them. Anyway, that's what's going on here. Oh, he's got a Fred. He's going to go somewhere. He's got a Fred. Everybody's just waiting for a block. Maybe we're going to get some local across the bridge this way ahead of everybody. Who knows? We'll see. Here's what we all been waiting for. Got one train on the other side of the bridge, that one that pulled up and stopped, and then this local on this side that pulled up and stopped, and now this guy looks like he's coming down to Maine, but I can't tell if he's just a power move or what. Yeah, it's just light power. I don't know where he's going, but he's going somewhere. Now his lights are off. He's just moving around. Probably going to pull up behind this block signal here and get the block to head back into the yard. Let's see if we can... Oops. There he goes. Changed ends. Look at that, the trailing headlight is on. Why do they do that? Oh, I was expecting him to bend around the curve. Well, maybe he's going. Yeah, he is. This is the train we're all waiting for. Yeah, it looks like a hopper train. Cool, everybody had to sit still for a dang old grain train. Here it comes. You know, gotta get that grain to port. Hello, woman. You're on your lunch break. Nobody took you to lunch. Oops. Cool, H1. 3828, tier 4. 1105, tier 1. We're going to have all kind of trains coming across the bridge. Sounds like we might got one coming from the Yakima side on the NP, as well as one coming from the SPNS side, the one that pulled up and stopped there about an hour and a half ago. He's going to hit the bridge out there. We'll watch the heritage cars from behind. Now, they may have pulled his DPU off, and that might have been what we saw swing around the Y there, as they pulled the DPU off of this baby, because he's river level all the way to Vancouver now via Wish Ram. They're not taking this one over the Stampede. They tried it a couple of times. I think they abandoned it because they had to use about 10 locomotives to get a regular grain train over it, and kind of defeated the purpose, if you ask me. Okay, we'll just pan out, watch it go. Yeah. Wow, I guess I am zoomed out pretty good. See, filming right into the sun, I am. I won't know which way he's swinging, but my guess is he's going to Wish Ram and Vancouver that way. And here's another boring shot. Of course, I'm on the wrong side, but there's no access on the other side, so gotta settle for what I can get. Looks like we got a DPU on the end of this one. $4.98 right there. $4.98 video evidence finally. $4.96 $5.55 Hey, that's a rare car number. No, it's not. It's a one of a kind, just like all the rest of them. Okay, let's get that DPU. No heritage cars today. What do we got for a DPU number? Let's see if we can catch it up there. Nope, we have to get it off the side of the locomotive. 43.55. And they left the window open. Is that open? Nah, it's closed. Oh, he's revving it up. Start pushing me, baby. He's either pushing or he's winding in and out of dynamic. I don't know these locomotives well enough. Patiently waiting to get on the main. Somebody's got to go out and switch a couple of tank cars. Oh, now I can hear his head end out there howling. He's gone by that other train already. So he is swinging to the left on the SP&S. His head end is probably way over there. Oh yeah, there he is. Oops. Don't know my own camera. There you go. Swinging like Tarzan through trees. On the same line. Not much elevation change there. Can we zoom in any closer? Oh, of course, look at this. That's all, folks. We'll zoom out and let her go. Maybe I'll catch the tail end of it later. About ready to pop out there, I'm not sure. I think it was pretty close to that. Oh, there it is. Pretty close to that gray hopper. Okay, guys. Well, I guess we'll see now who comes across next, whether it's the guy on the NP side, the guy on the SP&S side, or this guy on this side getting to the other side. Man, there's a lot of traffic down here, too. Cool. And they're giving him the block. Going on the SP&S side, I think that's the high signal is the SP&S route because it's the one that's used the most. There he goes. I think if he was lining the other way, he'd get a clear block because the other local looks like it's in the hole. See ya. Bridge is gobbling him up. There he is, way out there. Him and his 1-2 tank cars. There he comes. they'll let the one local back across while he's trying to clear the other freight sitting over there. We'll just have train after train after train here. Well, here's another westbound we're waiting for. Still holding those two on the other side. This 8234 and the 3900 Tier 4. Let's see if we can get that Tier 4. 3900. Can't see it now, but that's what it is. Tier 4, 3900. And he's got a yellow, at least he did a second ago. He's going to take that block. Oil can with a full-length roof lock on it. Yeah, he's not going to be very big. There's no DPU. Rear of it's coming by the other camera. Whistling Freddy. Thank you. see if we can hear that sucker with my long-range zoom microphone. I hear a lot of wind blowing. Across the river yet? Two units in a short light train, he'll fly down the track. He'll be at Wishram in about 15 minutes if he's 60. I didn't see any slow cars on there, so he's probably got to be track speed train. Anyway, we'll wait for the next one. Well, they're letting that other local across from the NP side. It might be that one I saw sneak up on that TCBY train and then shove backwards. He's been sitting over there for a little bit while both of these westbounds took off, but that other eastbound that pulled up and stopped over there is still sitting there. The guy's got about be half asleep by now, but they'll probably follow this guy right across the bridge as soon as he gets over the switch here, past the block, whatever, and give the other guy the block. Yeah, he's in a hurry to tie up here. Oh, they're bringing him in on the other track. Oh, he's moving, because he can go track speed. We should be able to see the other one pull across here. I can hear him honking. Well, maybe they're finally bringing him in. He's only been sitting over there for 2.5 hours. Yep, that's him. Lumber cars right behind the power. Finally, I'm glad I moved over here. I got a lot better shots. So we'll zoom the camera back. Catch him when he gets a little closer again. And here he comes. His tail end's already swung around. He's smaller than the last one that went by the other way. It looked like a bunch of cement hoppers on the rear end. We'll see. Here he comes. He's tired of sitting over there for 2.5 hours. He wants to come home, tie up, so he can go to the hotel. I think he's a Wishram crew. I don't know if they still station him out of there anymore or not. Maybe they station him out of Pasco here now. You just run him down and back all in one shift. Run him down and deadhead him back or something. Not sure about how they take care of business down here. And here he comes. Just a manifest freight train. Never seen any of those. white painters in real life before. And I have now. Yeah, here comes all those cement hoppers. Wow, look at those coil cars are kind of different. Hoppers, air slide, chip cars, no longer owned by the BNSF. They got too old, they didn't want to pay to fix them up. There's the cement hoppers I saw. My kind of train. Southern, wow. Wow, a little brown solution. Couple of green hoppers. That's it, folks. I think we're done here.